My name is Alex Moreno. My company name is Moreno Tile and Stone, and I serve Central Illinois, mainly the Galesburg, Peoria, Quad Cities area.
What makes a good granite fabricator?
And primarily, I think a local fabricator is the most important. If you go too far outside your area where you live, you're going to have a very difficult time getting service. Another thing that I find extremely important is the quality of the granite that you're going to buy. We as fabricators have a lot of opportunities to buy granite that has been damaged, that has cracks in it, that is warped, that was not filled at the factory, that might have some acid burn to it or sun damage that's been sitting out. We can hide a lot of those things during the selling of it. But after some time of it being in your home, those things will begin to manifest themselves and show. So, knowing that you can identify some of these things, like putting a straight edge on your granite, checking to see if it's been filled properly and that you don't have all these crypts, large crypts available or that show in your granite. But unfortunately, as a consumer, you just don't have the training to do that unless you do a lot of reading and you talk to a lot of fabricators about a lot of the pitfalls that are there. Machines tend to leave a lot of things square because you have to put another bit in to, like, bullnose the perimeter, on an undermount sink, the top edge of the sink. If you don't bullnose that slightly and they leave it square, it'll chip over time. The underside of the granite, you run your fingers along that. If it's not radiused underneath, you're going to have a sharp edge. There are sealers that we use and that we have access to in our industry that will seal your granite for a lifetime. You will never have to seal it again. But they cost money, and you will never know what kind of sealer your granite guy put in unless he shows you the bottle. Stone should last your whole life and generations. And if it's starting to fall apart, if the seams haven't been epoxied, if the sealer isn't holding up, if edges haven't been radiused, it won't hold up. I would have to say my largest strength, I would say there are two things. I have a college degree in art. I'm an art major. I bring a certain sensitivity to your environment. I'm sensitive to color, to texture. I try to understand the homeowner and see what they're really after in a stone, because stone can portray a warmth, movement. It can portray a lot of control, depending on the type of stone. So matching the stone with the individual is extremely important to me. Also making sure that it's, that the stone is at home in your kitchen, that it doesn't look like, oh my goodness, this was the wrong pick. It needs to feel like it's in the environment you've created. One other aspect that I feel is very, that I have that other fabricators don't, is that because I'm an art major and I'm a sculptor, and I do everything by hand, I cut by hand, I grind by hand, I polish by hand, there's a certain finished product that you get from an installer like myself, because I am constantly touching your stone just as you would.